नमस्कार। आई एम अपलोडिंग माई फर्स्ट वीडियो ऑन फार्माकोलॉजी फॉर मेडिकल, डेंटल, फार्मेसी और नर्सिंग स्टूडेंट्स, बट टूडे आई एम डिस्कस ऑन कॉम्पिटेंसी नंबर PH 1.1। दिस इज फॉर MBBS, दैट इज डिफाइन एंड डिस्क्राइब प्रिंसिपल इन फार्माकोलॉजी एंड फार्माकोथेरापेटिक्स। दिस इज सो टूडेज इंट्रोडक्शन टू फार्माकोलॉजी। सो व्हाट डू मीन बाई फार्माकोलॉजी? सो फार्माकोलॉजी इज बेसिकली साइंस ऑफ अ ड्रग्स, बिकॉज ऑल नॉलेज रिगार्डिंग ड्रग्स, आइदर एक्शन ऑफ द ड्रग, मैकेनिज्म ऑफ एक्शन, साइड इफेक्ट, एडवर्स ड्रग रिएक्शन, ऑल एस्पेक्ट्स ऑफ ड्रग्स हैज बीन स्टडीड इन फार्माकोलॉजी। सो फार्माकोलॉजी बेसिकली डिराइव्ड फ्रॉम ग्रीक वर्ड, that is pharmakon, pharmakon means drugs, and that is logos, logos means discourse, science or knowledge. So you can define pharmacology as it is the science of a drugs derived from two Greek words, that is pharmakon and logos. So it is the study of action of drugs on the living system. Pharmacology is basically is the study of action of drugs on living system, that is a pharmacology. Pharmacology encompasses all aspects of knowledge about drugs, more importantly those that are more relevant to effective and safe use of drugs for medical purposes. So that is real about pharmacology. So in pharmacology we study about drugs. So what do you mean by drugs? So drug is basically it is a French word, that is drogue. The drug is derived from French word drogue, that is means dry herb. In ancient India, herb is also considered as a drug, and the drug has been derived from French word, that is drogue, and drogue is the dry herb. Broadly, any single chemical substance which can be produced produce a biological response and used for the diagnosis, prevention and the treatment of a disease in man or animal is the drugs. ब्रॉडली इन अ ब्रॉड सेंस ड्रग कैन बी एनी सिंगल कंपाउंड और एंटिटी, कोई भी एक कंपाउंड से बायोलॉजिकल रिस्पॉन्स प्रोड्यूस करता हो फॉर द यूज फॉर द पर्पज ऑफ डायग्नोसिस, प्रिवेंशन एंड द ट्रीटमेंट। सो वाट अबाउट प्रोफ्लैक्सिस? सो एनी कंपाउंड विच इज यूज फॉर द प्रोफ्लैक्सिस, दैट इज ड्रग और नॉट? सो दिस कैन नॉट बाई दिस कैन नॉट कवर्ड इन अ ड्रग डेफिनेशन ब्रॉडली। दैट्स वाई WHO has defined drug in a well manner. So as per WHO, drug is any substance or a product that is used or intended to be used to modify, explore physiological system or pathological state for the benefit of the recipient. So in broad term, that is drug is used for the diagnosis, prevention, treatment, but prophylaxis is not considered. So that's why WHO has defined any substance or product that is used or intended to be used to modify or explore pathological, physiological system or the pathological state for the benefit of the recipient. As far as exam is concerned, we have to memorize a definition of drug as per WHO. This is introduction to pharmacology, so we'll discuss about history also. So as far as history is concerned, the Indian and the Chinese writings are the oldest written document in medicine, because earliest pharmacological writings are from Vedas in India, and Atharva Veda, I think it is the oldest written document as for pharmacological evidence was there. And ancient Indian physician Charaka and Susu described many herbal drugs, and they have also described many medicinal plant in their books that called Charaka Samhita and Susu Samhita in ancient India. So ancient Indian books or ancient Indian literature has a great contribution in the pharmacology, nowadays modern pharmacology also. However, modern pharmacology were started from the 18th century. Claude Bernard and F. Magnedi were started animal experiments primarily aim to understanding of physical process in the 18th century, and also attempted them to study the effect on certain drugs. So from there, modern pharmacology has been started from the 18th century. After that, pharmacology as an experimental science, pharmacology as an experimental science was ushered by Rudolf Buchim, who founded the first institute of pharmacology in 1847. So Oswald Schimberg, regarded as the father of pharmacology, propounded some fundamental concept of pharmacology. So after the opening of first institute of pharmacology in 1847 in Germany by Rudolf Buchim, Oswald Schimberg has given many fundamental concepts in pharmacology. From there, many drugs have been purified, chemically characterized, and vast variety of highly potent and selective new drugs have been developed. And because of this contribution, this Oswald Schimberg regarded as the considered as the father of pharmacology. It is very important question for Viva and for examination as concerned. So question is, who is the father of pharmacology? So answer is Oswald Schimberg. Why it is considered as the father of pharmacology? Because he has given a many fundamental concept in pharmacology, in modern pharmacology. From there we have synthesized, purified drugs, and nowadays many highly potent and selective new drugs have been developed because of this. That's why he has been regarded as the father of pharmacology. Sources of drugs. So from which sources we can derive the drugs? So the sources could be natural. The sources could be natural, synthetic, and biotechnology. All the drugs which has been nowadays available in market can be synthesized naturally, synthetically, or biotechnologically. During the ancient times, many drugs used as a plant sources, or from the plant sources, from there nowadays we can synthesize. So in natural sources, the drug can be synthesized from plants. The many plants contain biologically active substance, and the oldest sources of the drugs nowadays in ancient India, the whole plant can be were used for the treatment of the diseases. Though from the plant we can synthesize the drugs. Another is the alkaloids. So alkaloid is basically also from the plant sources. The natural active compound is called the alkaloids. So these are basically alkali nitrogenous bases having potent activity, like atropine, morphine, quinine, reserpine, ephedrine. These are the active compound of the particular plant. That is the natural sources. The drug is also synthesized from glycosides. These compound consists of heterocyclic non-sugar moiety. You can see a glycone linked to sugar moiety through ether linkage. Cardiac glycoside, digoxin, uabin are the best known glycosidic drugs. The drug can be synthesized from animal also. Drug can be synthesized from animal also. That is, insulin, heparin can synthesize from animals. Nowadays, porcine insulin were there. Synthesized from animal. But insulin nowadays also synthesized synthetically or genetic engineering technology. But insulin can be synthesized from animal also. Ferrous sulfate, magnesium sulfate can be synthesized from minerals. Some antibiotics like penicillin, streptomycin, gisoferbin synthesized from microorganisms. So these are synthesized naturally. These are available in natural form. From directly you can synthesize from this particular without alteration of the chemical structure. So other drug can be synthesized synthetically also. So in synthetic, most drugs used today are synthetics. Synthetic drugs basically synthesize a chemical alteration of the chemical alteration in the chemical structure, that aspirin, paracetamol, omeprazole. So these can be synthesized on alteration of in a chemical structure of particular drugs. So resulting drugs are synthetic drugs. Another sources of drugs are biotechnology. So use of biotechnology in the production of drugs and biological has helped to treat many diseases nowadays. Now it has been possible to synthesize many congeners with minor modification because of biotechnological techniques. and these are some techniques from which we can synthesize the drug, like cell culture, urokinase cell culture, urokinase from cultured human kidney cell. Drugs are also produced by genetic engineering technology. Human insulin, human growth hormone, hepatitis B vaccine nowadays synthesized from genetic engineering. Another hybridoma techniques, monoclonal antibodies like rituximab can be synthesized from hybridoma techniques. So because of biotechnological techniques, nowadays many drugs have been synthesizing from the help of biotechnology techniques. Drug categories. So all the drugs in pharmacology can be categorized under two types. One is a non-prescription drugs. Non-prescription drugs are those drugs which can be sold from the pharmacy without prescription of the drugs. So that is called non-prescription drug. Anybody can go and purchase the drug without prescription of the clinician or the registered doctors. That is non-prescription drug. Another is a prescription drugs. So those drugs which cannot sold or no one can buy without the prescription of clinician or the registered doctor, that is called prescription drugs. And prescription drugs basically classified under various schedules and drug act and can be sold only after prescribed by the clinician. So those all the drugs can be categorized either OTC drugs, can buy without prescription of the drugs, or prescription drugs sold only after the prescription of the clinician. Apart from this, there are some orphan drugs are also there. So orphan drugs are basically also used for the diagnosis, treatment and prevention of the rare diseases. So this is used for the rare diseases. So none of the manufacturer interested to manufacture these types of drugs because of less revenue collection, and because of these are the rare used for the rare diseases and chances of selling is a very rare and very low. That's why nobody interested. That's why this condition disease is so rare that there is no expectation that the cost of research and manufacturer can be recovered from the sale of the drugs. So manufacturer cannot recover the cost during the research or manufacturing. That's why nobody interested to manufacture these types of drug, that is called orphan drugs. So for the manufacture of orphan drugs, government basically giving a special package for the manufacturer to manufacture that types of drugs, because private manufacturer or nobody interested to manufacture of these types of drugs. That is, it is called orphan drugs. Orphan drugs are basically sodium nitrate, protamine sulfate, anti-digoxin antibodies, triiodothyronine. This is the important drugs, but this is used for the very rare diseases. So chances of sale is very rare, very few. So the manufacturer does not get sufficient money or sufficient cost because of this. They are not interested to manufacture these types of drugs. That's why it is called the orphan drugs. Division of pharmacology. So whole pharmacology can be divided into two parts, that is pharmacokinetics and pharmacodynamics. Pharmacokinetics and the pharmacodynamics. Pharmacokinetic is basically what the body does to the drug. Basically it is the movement of drug in the body. And pharmacokinetic is the movement of drug in the body, and pharmacodynamic is the what the drug does to the body, what the drug is going to do into the body. So we'll discuss one by one. Pharmacokinetics. So pharmacokinetic, as the name suggests, kinesis means the movement. So it is refers to the movement of drug in the body and the alteration of drug by the body. That is called pharmacokinetic. In pharmacokinetic, we can study absorption, distribution, metabolism and excretion. And these absorption, distribution, metabolism, excretion does by the body to the drugs. You can memorize as A, D, M, E. So a study of absorption, distribution, metabolism and excretion. A study of A, D, M, E is called the pharmacokinetic. And later in another full lecture, we'll discuss on pharmacokinetic one by one, on absorption, distribution, metabolism, excretion. This is just for introductory lecture. What do you mean by pharmacokinetic? So pharmacokinetic is the द नेम सजेस्ट डायनामिक्स, डायनामिक मीन्स एक्शन पावर. सो एज पर डेफिनेशन दिस रेफर्स टू फिजियोलॉजिकल बायोलॉजिकल इफेक्ट्स ऑफ द ड्रग्स एंड देयर मैकेनिज्म ऑफ एक्शन इन द बॉडी. सो इन योर बॉडी द ड्रग इज डूइंग समथिंग इन द बॉडी वार दैट इज इन माइक्रोमोलिकुलर लेवल, सब सेलुलर लेवल, ऑर्गन सिस्टम लेवल, दैट इज कॉल्ड फार्माकोडायनामिक्स. सो फार्माकोडायनामिक द स्टडी ऑफ एक्शन ऑफ ड्रग इन द बॉडी. अदर इंपॉर्टेंट डिविजन ऑफ फार्माकोलॉजी दैट इज एक्सपेरिमेंटल फार्माकोलॉजी, इवैल्यूएशन ऑफ ड्रग ऑन एक्शन इन एनिमल्स. क्लिनिकल फार्माकोलॉजी, इवैल्यूएशन ऑफ ड्रग एक्शन इन ह्यूमंस. फार्माकोथेरापेटिक्स, एप्लीकेशन ऑफ फार्माकोलॉजिकल इन्फॉर्मेशन टुगेदर विद नॉलेज ऑफ डिसीजेस फॉर इट्स प्रिवेंशन, मिटिगेशन एंड द क्योर. केमोथेरापी, ट्रीटमेंट ऑफ सिस्टमिक इन्फेक्शन, मैलिग्नेंसीज विद स्पेसिफिक ड्रग्स दैट ऑफ सिलेक्टिव टॉक्सिसिटी फॉर द इन्फेक्टिव ऑर्गेनिज्म मैलिग्नेंट सेल with minimal effect on the horse cell. Toxicology, the study of poisonous effect of the drugs. Pharmacovigilance, the study deals with the ADR. Pharmacogenetics, the study of genetic influences on the response to the drugs. Pharmacogenomics, use of genetic information to guide the choice of the drug therapy. Pharmacoepidemiology, study of drug effect at the population level. Pharmacoeconomic, the cost effective and the cost efficacy of the drugs. And health economics is studied under the pharmacoeconomics. Another important branches of the pharmacology is the pharmacy, deals with the compounding and dispensing of the drug, and pharmacy is a very important part of the hospitals. So these are the important branches of pharmacology other than pharmacokinetic and the pharmacodynamic. The main two branches are pharmacokinetic and pharmacodynamic. Whole pharmacology will be studied under this, and apart from pharmacokinetic and pharmacodynamic, these are some important branches of the pharmacology. Sources of information, the drug information can be taken from these sources. These can be called drug compendia, known as pharmacopoeias or formularies, you can say. So pharmacopoeias and formularies are the sources of the drug from where we can get knowledge about drug. These can be classified as official or the non-official. As per official compendia, this is called British pharmacopoeia, United States pharmacopoeia and Indian pharmacopoeias. Pharmacopoeia is nothing but this is the book consisting of all the information regarding the drugs you can get from pharmacopoeias. All the countries have this own pharmacopoeia, but main important pharmacopoeias famous in the world are British pharmacopoeia, United States pharmacopoeia and Indian pharmacopoeia. British pharmacopoeia formulated by Pharmaceutical Codex by Pharmaceutical Society of Great Britain. United States pharmacopoeia by national, it is a national formulary by American Pharmaceutical Association, and Indian pharmacopoeia is a national formulary of India. So all the drugs manufacturing India are found in India has been consisting in the Indian pharmacopoeia. This is official drug information sources of India. So there are some non-official compendia serve as a sources of drug information both by generic name and the trade name. So the EMA drug evaluation by American Medical Association and the Council on the Drugs, Modern Drug Encyclopedia by Yoki Medical Books, New York, Physician Desk Response by Medical Economics Publication, USA, Martindale Extra Pharmacopoeias by Pharmaceutical Society of Great Britain. So these are also drug information sources from where we can get knowledge about drugs. But thank you. So today we discuss about introduction to pharmacology, and this is the first lecture of pharmacology I am uploading on YouTube. So if you think this is helping you, or content is good for you or helpful for you, please like my video and subscribe my YouTube channels. Subsequently, I will uploading lecture on pharmacology one by one, from general pharmacology to all the systemic pharmacology. So please wait for another lecture.